became seriously interested in photography at the age of 21. From the outset, I wanted to step a less trodden path, and to that end, started to use colour film and Kokin filters to achieve my impressionistic visions. I would use multi-image and colour filters along with double exposure. I started photographing the City of London, having moved closer to the centre from Southall, on the outskirts where I grew up. I would wander about the city on a Sunday with my bag of tricks, looking to be inspired by the tourist spots. Most roads seemed to lead me to Hyde Park and the Serpentine, around which I would shoot people at their leisure activities. Later that first summer, it entered my head to start experimenting with the film emulsion. I started using different films and techniques to distort the emulsion until I hit upon the optimal combination. The technique created the bubbles, distortion, and color shifts all at the same time. I had some control over it, but what I most liked about it was its randomness. What I loved about it was like alchemy and could magically turn an ordinary picture into gold, but conversely, it could destroy a good one. I had to work on the originals, and many would go in the bin because they disintegrated. I also could not do too many at once because of the noxious fumes the process created. The following year, I discovered Surrealism, which is the work I'm better known for, winning awards and publishing books of my work. These magical pictorialist pictures took a back seat, and I used the technique for my hobby photography. I had a one-man exhibition of them in 1988 and never showed them again, but I would still photograph London on occasion. About a decade later, I bought a car and would sometimes use the technique on my road trips through Britain. I drove to places such as Devon and Cornwall, North and South Wales, Yorkshire Dales and Cumbria, photographing the British at play. By my images of London, I wanted to take a tourist eye view, because that is what I considered myself. I would later use the process on the film, then file them away. People have sometimes described the images as trippy or psychedelic, but the word that most often comes to mind is nostalgia. It is a dreamscape that gives you a childlike view of the world, where magic could be just around the corner, and adults seem really old, and rooms much bigger. It is like looking through a distorted lens where everything is recognizable but yet strange. The remembrance of holidays spent with their families at the seaside often comes to them. For me, these are my holiday snaps. While others snap their kin in front of the local landmark, I snapped them at play and created an almost remembered candy-coloured fantasy world where the sun is nearly always shining and after some begging their parents are just about to buy them another ice cream.